funniest guy in the squad. Definitely not Ethan. Definitely not Adamola. No way. I like to work hard every day and try to get better. Yeah, ich spreche ganz gut Deutsch. The simple answer is never. I play Xbox because all my friends in America have Xbox. So to play with him, I might have to get a PlayStation, but for right now, I'm keeping my Xbox. I can't answer that question. That's a terrible question. Okay. No.
What league?
No, Bundesliga.
Of course.
RB Leipzig.
Yeah.
Ooh, I think that the biggest change from MLS to the Bundesliga would be the speed of play. I think that you have to think much quicker, you have to play much quicker. Obviously, the level and quality of the players is even higher than in the MLS, so coming here, that has probably been the biggest change for me. No, Christian is a close friend of mine, so I'm excited to watch him now, obviously, at Chelsea. He's a top player, and obviously what he did at Dortmund kind of set the way for a lot of young Americans and also helped my decision when I came to the Bundesliga, because I saw how successful he was with Dortmund. So close friend of mine, but obviously we battle with each other every time we play against each other and when we play with each other with the national team. I wouldn't say I'm so good. I like to work hard every day and try to get better, but for me, I think that the biggest thing is being humble and just going about your work every single day and trying to get better. The biggest difference would be about there's 12 million people less in Leipzig, but no, it's a smaller city, but for me, I like being in a smaller city, actually, because growing up in such a big area with so many people, traffic all the time, hard to get around. Here, it's a little bit more quiet, a little bit more peaceful, not always in a rush to get places. I like that kind of lifestyle. I started playing soccer when I was about, 4 years old, I think. I think my mom was my first coach as well, so that was fun. Definitely not Ethan. Definitely not Adamola. Funniest guy in the squad. I don't know, we have a couple funny guys. Maybe Nordy, maybe Ibu. One of the French guys for sure. They're hilarious. As a basketball player, I think Jordan. As a person, LeBron, for all the things that he does for the community and everything like that. Messi or Ronaldo? I'm a Messi fan. Yeah. So growing up, I was a huge Thierry Henry fan. So when he was at Arsenal, I just watched a lot of Arsenal games and supported him mostly. So even when he made the transition to New York, that was really cool for me, because I was in the academy and I had, you know, my role model and the person that I looked up to playing in the professional ranks where I wanted to be. So yeah. Playing a Champions League game, playing my first Champions League game. I missed out on the opportunity to play in the first 6 months, so now I'm excited to hopefully have an opportunity to play in one. I'll go back to the USA one day, of course. To play, I don't know, we'll see where my career takes me. But I think that, of course, I'm not necessarily the type of person to get homesick, but of course, at times I miss my family, I miss my brothers, hanging out, and just being in my home city. Of course, I miss it. Swedish is probably easier than German, to be honest with you. No, but Forsberg, great guy. I'm so happy he speaks English as well. Thank you. Ooh, favorite rapper. J. Cole is my favorite. Been my favorite since I was growing up. Yeah, so J. Cole. Oh, geez, that's a hard question. 49ers are good this year, actually. Yeah, it could actually be the 49ers this year. If I had to guess a team, Jimmy G having a good season himself, so I'm gonna have to go with the 49ers, yeah. Consistency, I think, is the biggest thing for me. So I would say that making the Champions League every single year and continuing our rise in that. Oh man, I really like Kawhi Leonard right now. I like watching how this guy plays, how he carries himself, very humble guy. Yeah, Kawhi Leonard's probably my favorite. Someone that I like a lot, like as a player, is N'Golo Kanté. He's one of my favorite players. So even when the U.S., when I was with the U.S. national team and we had the opportunity to play against France before they went to the World Cup, I was able to swap jerseys with him, which was really cool. So now I have a Kanté jersey. Had the opportunity to play against him, and I just like how he plays. So yeah. Yeah, we had a preseason. The preseason game against Galatasaray was actually my first game. So, yeah. So I came on at halftime, and yeah, getting those first 45 minutes was really good because it was obviously a preseason game, so it didn't really have much meaning. But also, I was able to kind of settle in a little bit more and let everyone know that, you know, I was here to play and that I have a little bit of quality. So that got my confidence up, and I was excited to then get into the Bundesliga games. It was an easier transition than I expected because not only are the philosophies of how we play very similar, but also when Jesse Marsh was here, he obviously helped me with the transition a lot. He was a coach that signed me in New York when I was 15 or 16 years old. So having someone that I knew I could speak to, he made me more comfortable and times that I felt uncomfortable. So that was definitely helpful. And then, yeah, the football, you know, every time that I'm out on the pitch, I'm just having fun. So that took care of itself. And as I was able to establish myself with the team and gain respect from everybody, it got a lot easier. No, never. I think this was For my career, I couldn't think of a better place that I could be, not only for development, but now Leipzig is really turning into a team that's, you know, a top club in the world. So as long as we continue the rise, like I said, in the Champions League, you know, and win championships, whether it's competing for the Bundesliga every year, competing for the Pokal, we're a real top club now, and I'm excited to be here and develop. I think that obviously doing something within football would be great. I don't know if it would be coaching, maybe going back to the U.S. and working within MLS or something like that at New York, which was a club that meant a lot to me when I was young, and still does. But in school right now, I'm studying sports psychology for a degree from college, so maybe something in that as well. We'll see. Ich spreche ganz gut Deutsch.
Wird besser langsam oder ist es schwierig?
Es ist ein bisschen schwierig, especially für eine englische Sprache. Yeah.
Ja.
Ja. There's so many good places in New York. some of the top places to go. I mean, obviously the 9/11 memorial is something that's really, really cool and something that everyone should see, especially if they're in New York. One of my favorite places in New York is Brooklyn. It's kind of a different vibe. It's similar to Leipzig, like a lot of graffiti, a lot of artists go and express themselves there. And there's really good views of Manhattan. So I would say Brooklyn and the 9/11 memorial. Yeah, it was really exciting for me. Very relieving as well, because it was good to not only, you know, be training and feeling good, but to go and get a game. I wasn't necessarily expecting to play almost a full game right before the break, but obviously the coach trusted me and I was able to go out, and it was even better to not only play but get 3 points as well. So I was excited. Ethan and Adamola, both of them, yeah. Playing in the Pokal final last year, although we lost, it was an amazing experience, like walking out and seeing our fans on one side, the Bayern fans on the other side. I thought it was so cool how it's like split on one end and then the other, and then it's mixed in the middle. So that experience was amazing, because I mean, that was probably the biggest game of my career so far. Really excited. I think it's a good draw for us. I think they're a team that obviously with a new manager has been playing pretty well. So now with the opportunity to go there, play in a new stadium in Tottenham will be really cool. And it's a big challenge for us, but that's what we wanted. We wanted a team that, you know, we have the opportunity that we can beat, but also a team that has a lot of history to their team. So we're all really, really excited to go to London and face off against a good opponent. There's not a specific player I like to play against. Of course, I mean, one that makes my job easy, so a lazy player. From my family, my mom loved soccer, but she also let me play any sport that I wanted to. So when I was young, I played every sport there was: basketball, baseball, soccer, football, everything. And then I just decided that I wanted to choose soccer and continue to play it. So I'd probably say my mom had the biggest influence on just letting me play as many sports as I wanted. And then I really liked soccer because I love to run around, and soccer, you get to run around the most, so I picked that. New York, my first professional goal. I'm trying to think. Oh, my first professional goal was against Chelsea, actually. When we played, that was my professional debut when I was 16. We played against Chelsea in some tournament in the US. And that's when I scored my first goal. And that was a pretty good feeling, because, you know, it was one thing to be like a 16-year-old playing against Chelsea, but then to like score when like Hazard and like all these guys are on the field was a good moment.
Tyler Adams. Tyler Adams.
No way. Oh. Is he must be from New York then. Oh, okay. That's so funny.
He's cute.
Yeah, it's good.